For years, I struggled driving my E46 at night because of my dim headlights. I changed the xenon bulbs, but there was hardly any improvement. I thought my only option was to buy new headlights until I read about headlight retrofit kits. My dim headlight issue was caused by the burn reflectors. It seems to be a common issue on the E46s with ZKW headlights. The material used for these reflectors appears to be prone to burnout. Since these reflectors cannot be purchased, instead of buying new headlights for around $400 each, I invested in a retrofit kit from Retrofit Lab that cost me around $200 for the set. It's been over a year since I retrofitted my headlights and I'm still very happy with the results. I hope after watching this video you're able to get a good idea of the process. My goal is to show a detailed process from beginning to end, the issues I came across, and how I dealt with them. Let's go. These are my burn reflectors, and as you can see, there's hardly any reflective surface left. You can check your headlights to see if you have burn reflectors by removing this plastic cover. If the top of your reflector looks like mine, chances are, this is your problem. For this retrofit, I will be using a kit from Retrofit Lab, Phillips screwdriver, 8mm socket with a ratchet and long extension, T10 and T20 screw bits, drill with a 1/8 drill bit, wire cutters, shrink tube, soldering iron, 4 magnets, and epoxy glue. To remove the headlight, I use a Phillips screwdriver to loosen the screw that holds the blinker. No need to unscrew it completely, just do a few turns and the blinker can be taken out. The bulb socket comes up with a quarter turn. I remove 4 8mm screws, 3 on the top, 1 on the side, and 1 on the back. The bottom trim can be removed by pulling on it. There are 4 connectors behind the headlight. They come off by pressing down on their tab. I worked on each headlight at a time, so that when I finished with one, I could put it back on the car and adjust the cutoff level of the retrofitted light to match the old one. The kit that I chose was the BMW 3 E46 98205 for Bi-Xenon HID headlights made by ZKW. Since I'm in the US, the projector version I got was Mini D1S/D2S DOT cutoff RHT for right-hand traffic. I didn't order any new bulbs since I plan to use my old ones. I bought this kit in January of 2023, and there's a chance that by the time you're watching this video, the kit and instructions might have changed. The kit came with 2 E46 shrouds, 2 Aran Mini D2S projectors, 2 Aran H7 high beam splitter cables, 1 solenoid connector wire, 4 bulb holders, and 1 metal drill template. To start the headlight disassembly process, I remove the upper headlight gasket by unhooking it from these 5 points. For the lens, I pull up on each tab to unhook it. I then started pulling on the lens until it came off. This black frame comes off by gently pulling from the tabs on each corner. The back covers are very easy to remove. The high beam connector can be removed by pulling on it. And the xenon connector is removed by turning it counterclockwise. To disconnect the solenoid wire, I use a pair of pliers and pull on the connector. The next step is to remove this frame. I use a Phillips head screwdriver and turn the height adjustment clockwise all the way. The frame needs to be unhooked from these 3 spots, one from the side, from a small ball at the bottom, and the hardest at the top. Using a flathead screwdriver, 2 small plastic hooks need to be pushed out to unhook them from this round black plastic. Ooh. This is the small ball that was hooked at the bottom. The condition of the wires inside this headlight was way better than in the other. Here's what I had to deal with in the other headlight. Most of the wires were brittle and would peel off when I touched them. To avoid any potential shorts, I opted to replace some of them and use shrink tube to insulate others. The process was straightforward, but it was time consuming. I was happy how it came out, but if I had to do it again, I would probably replace all the wires instead of re-insulating them using shrink tube. Another issue that I came across was this sign of humidity caused by a crack in the low beam cover, so I used epoxy glue to seal it. To remove the burn reflectors from the frame, I had to unscrew 3 T20s and 1 T10 screw. Both reflectors were in pretty bad condition. To remove the projector lens, I used a flat screwdriver and pushed out these plastic hooks. Once unhooked, I pushed the lens up to separate it from the shroud. The kit came with a metal template for marking the mounting holes, but I couldn't get the new projector to align properly, since the silver pins were in the way. Using the projector, I made sure it sat flush, got it as close as possible to the template holes, and marked new mounting holes. Once I had the new markings, I proceeded to drill 3 pilot holes, using a small drill bit at first, and then a 1/8 bit, which was perfect for these screws. I spin the screw to heat it up, and then screw it in to make the threads. I also removed these 3 grommets, which I'll be using between the projector and the frame. The next step is to screw the projector into the frame. The kit came with 2 styles of bulb holders. This was the correct one for my unit. Since there are several options to choose from when it comes to retrofit kits, make sure the kit contains all the correct items for your headlight. The bulb holder is one of the essentials. The xenon bulb has a small notch on the top, and it only goes one way. The bulb gets secured by locking these 2 metal clips. For the shroud, I remove these 2 inside clips. I also removed these 3 plastic bits. With those removed, the projector was now sitting flush. The instructions on the kit set to glue the shroud to the projector, but I wanted a more flexible solution, and here's what I did. I had a few of these magnets around, and I glued them to the inside of the shroud using epoxy. This way I could adjust and remove them if needed. About 30 minutes later, the epoxy hardened and I was able to remove the projector. It was now time to put everything back. I aligned the top hook on the back of the frame and pushed until it snapped in. I made sure the side pin was inside the hole. And last, I pushed at the bottom until the small ball on the back snapped in. The old solenoid cable used to connect at the back, but in the new projector, it connects at the front. I plugged in the solenoid wire in the front, passed it through the bottom. In the back, I cut the wire here, and also cut off the old connector. For the solenoid cable, I opted to cut both the old and the new wires, and solder the new connector, instead of using the adapter provided. I did this because my old solenoid wire was brittle, and I needed to insulate it using shrink tube. I tinned the wires before soldering them together. I measured and cut the shrink tube as needed to re-insulate the wire and cover the solder joint. The shrink tube goes first before soldering. According to the instructions from the kit, there's no polarity in the solenoid wires, so I soldered brown with red and white with green. I used this burner since I didn't have a heat gun. I shrunk the tip of the tubes to be able to push it as far down as it could go. I then put back the connector for the xenon bulb, the high beam, and the covers. While putting back this black piece, I pushed down from this edge and I broke the locking tab.
And I broke this one. God.
I glued it back using crazy glue. When putting it back, it's best to push it down on the tab. By having glued the magnets on the inside of the shroud, I can easily snap it into the projector and adjust it as needed. It's easier to remove, and it gives me access to the mounting screws of the projector. To reinstall the lens, I aligned it on the top right and began pressing it into the housing. I firmly pressed on the lens by each tab to make sure it was securely locked. The headlight gasket was the last item. Since I didn't have any specific instructions on how to properly level the headlights, I opted for working on one headlight at a time. I used the old headlight as a reference to adjust and match the level of the retrofitted one. This ensured a close match between the two. I then removed and retrofitted the second headlight. Once I had it back in the car, I adjusted its level to match the first one. The difference in light output is huge. Before, it felt as if I had candles in my headlights. It was barely visible, the cars behind me light the way. Passengers often asked me if I had the lights on, and it was just embarrassing. As I said before, it's been over a year since I did this retrofit. I barely got to edit this video. I haven't had any issues, I'm still very happy with the results, and I only wish I would have done this way sooner. Thank you for watching this video, I hope you guys find it useful, and don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, share. I'll see you guys on the next one.